Good day to everyone. Last Wednesday, May 6, the Catholic Church celebrated the Feast of St. Dominic Savio. Who is Dominic Savio? Dominic Savio was born on April 2, 1842 in the village of Rivacieri near Turin, Italy. His parents were Charles Savio, a blacksmith, and Bridget Savio, a seamstress. He died in Muraldo on March 9, 1857 at the age of 14. He was declared venerable by Pope Pius XI on 1933. And he was declared beatified on March 9, 1950 and was canonized on June 12, 1954 by Pope Pius XII. He is the patron saint for choir boys and falsely accused people. He was previously the youngest non-martyr to be canonized in the Catholic Church. Path to Holiness of Saint Dominic Savio. When he was 2 years old, his family went back to their native place in Murialdo. His parents were a big influence on the young Dominic Savio, as they were very devout Catholics. When he was 4 years old, he was able to memorize and recite morning and evening prayers, angelus prayers, and prayer before meals. Because of this, he would often remind others they forgot to recite their prayer. An example of this is when a stranger was eating with his family. The stranger forgot to recite the prayer before meals. Because of this, Dominic Savio refused to eat dinner with them. When he reached the age of 5, he was already able to serve during Mass. When he reached the age of 7, he was able to receive his first Holy Communion. This was an exemption of the normal practice at that time, as a child must reach the age of 12 before receiving the first Holy Communion. The parish priest hesitated at first, then consulted other parish priests because Dominic Savio was only 7 years old. But because of the young boy's disposition and knowledge, was allowed to receive his first Holy Communion. He also wrote 4 promises in a little book. I go to confession often, receive Holy Communion as my confessor allows. I wish to sanctify Sundays and feast days fully. My friends shall be Jesus and Mary, and death rather than sin. He first met Don Bosco in October 1854, together with his father in his oratory at Turin. During this meeting, Don Bosco wanted to test Dominic Savio's knowledge and understanding of the Catholic faith by handing him over a copy of the Catholic's reading. He expected Dominic Savio to give him an answer the next day, but was surprised when he was able to recite what were written in the Catholic readings and was able to explain their importance to the Catholic faith in 10 minutes. He also told Don Bosco his intention that he wanted to become a priest and asked to study in the oratory of St. Francis de Sales in Turin. Don Bosco then agreed to take in Dominic Savio. When he arrived at the oratory in Turin, Dominic Savio renewed his first Holy Communion promises written in a little book. After staying in the oratory for 6 months, he delivered a speech on the path to sainthood. He focused on 3 points. It is God's will that we become saints. It is easy to become a saint, and there are great rewards for saints in heaven. Dominic Savio asked himself, how could I become a saint? So we did physical penances such as putting stones and pieces of food in his bed, wearing thin clothes during winter time, and fasting on bread and water. Don Bosco noticed these acts and corrected him and said to him, the best penance to do is to do his best in his studies, and that obedience is the best sacrifice there is. There was an instance where two boys put snow and rubbish in a school stove, and they falsely accused Dominic Savio of committing such acts. He did not deny these accusations, and the teacher scolded him. Later, they found out it was the two boys who committed such acts, and asked Dominic Savio why he did not deny their accusations. He said he was just imitating how the Lord acted when he was persecuted and crucified on the cross. This led him to be called as a patron saint for falsely accused people. Pope Pius IX proclaimed the dogma of the Immaculate Conception. Dominic consecrated himself to Mary and became holier. This also led him, with his friends, in 1856 to found the Immaculate Conception Sodality that is dedicated to apostolic mission and peer ministry. When death was approaching Dominic Savio, he asked his parents to have a parish priest come to their home so that he could have his last confession. When the parish priest reached their home, he administered the sacrament of reconciliation and anointing of the sick to him. After this was done, he asked his father to recite him the prayers to exercise of a happy death. Thank you for listening, and I hope you learned something about Dominic Savio and how he is a great inspiration for the youth.